Right now, solar panels are on the 200 watt range. Do you ever see them going to 300 watts? Is a question I asked John Shaw, project engineer for Bella Energy.
Comparable size?
Absolutely. Any manufacturer could do that right now. So here's the distinction. You really shouldn't look at how many watts a panel has, but rather how many watts per square feet can be attained. So the point is, for example, behind you is a Sanyo 200. If you increase the footprint of that panel by 50%, it's a 300 watt panel.
Right.
So, I mean, the reality is what we, you need to be looking at to measure the progress of the technology is how many watts per square foot. All right. So instead of saying, do we think there'll ever be a 300 watt panel, which surely there will be, likely even next year, a better way to, I think, to get at the point of your question is say, do you think we'll ever be able to achieve a 300 watt panel in 15 square feet?
Okay.
And yeah, I do. Right now, standard efficiency panels are in the ballpark of about 12 watts per square foot. It ranges from 10 to 13 or so. Standard efficiency panels would be Evergreens, Sharps, Kyoceras, Schott, Suntech, et cetera, et cetera. And keep in mind, this is kind of the residentially affordable panels. Of course, NASA works with panels which are, maybe 30 watts per square foot right now, but you're talking $1 million a panel.
Okay.
So then there are high efficiency panels, and at least that of the ones we know of, there's SunPower and Sanyo. And SunPower and Sanyo are both approximately 15 watts per square foot.
Okay.
Those are high efficiency panels. Both are very good products. Sanyo, I believe, has a little bit of an edge because the Sanyo cells have an amorphous or thin film wrap around the silicon cell, which allows them to maintain higher production in high heat. So then there's one more reason, and I'll tie these in. The Sanyos are shipped with a minus zero and a plus 5%. So when you buy a 200 watt Sanyo panel, you will get, hypothetically in standard test conditions, 75 degrees at sea level, you will get 200 watts or up to 210 watts. All other panels, including specifically SunPower's, come with a plus or minus 5%, plus or minus 5%. So for example, you could buy a 210 watt SunPower cell and it could actually perform at 199 watts, where you're buying a 200 watt Sanyo cell and it could perform at 210 watts, but no less than 200 watts.
Nice. Okay.
And so, that combined with the fact that the Sanyos will outperform a SunPower, apples to apples, same azimuth and pitch, in high heat because of this amorphous thin film wrap by 10% in high heat, peak days, peak hours, we feel the Sanyos are a better panel.
Wow.
Now, I have to say, Sanyos are also more expensive than the SunPower, so we can't touch the SunPower price.
Oh.
We can touch it with standard efficiency panels. We can blow it out of the water with standard efficiency panels. But if you're talking high efficiency, SunPower and Sanyo, I think the Sanyo is a better panel, but the SunPower is definitely better priced.